Karuk tribe by Eva Nunez
and Vanessa Ramirez. Native American tribe and geographic location. They're the Karuk tribe. It's located in the northern part of California with lands in Humboldt and Siskiyou counties. And their primary locations are Happy Camp, Orleans, Sunbar, and Eureka.
Geographic features. The major river that flows past the Karuk tribe is the Camelot River, or even the Scott River. Their tribe seems to live within the Camelot National Forest region. They're surrounded by many pine and oak trees. These land features provide many grasslands and huge mountain slopes. The nearest coastline is Happy Camp. Climate of the region. Season/weather. Typical weather could be cold and rainy throughout the winter, and most of the time hot and dry throughout the summer. Vegetation. The rivers offer water and food. Karuk people rely on mixed fire severity rhymes. They burn at different seasons at different intensities for the tribe's sustenance and well-being. Lots of oak trees, not many redwood trees.
Main food source and types of agriculture. Common foods they ate were salmon, Pacific lamprey, sturgeons, and many other aquatic species. Deer, eel, as you could tell, they were a big fan of hunting. Berries, yahoo, acorns, by the looks of the agriculture methods, were fishing, hunting, and farming. Homes and buildings. Their homes were shaped like domes and covered with bark mats, animal hides, and leaves. Or they would either live in round mounds with mud plaster walls and branches, dried grass as roofs.
Types of materials for crafts and clothing. Mainly made out of fur, animal hide, and plant materials. But to be specific, women wore skirts made from long dried grass, beads, and shells. Both men and women wore ponchos made out of deerskin for cold and rainy weather, and wore moccasins as shoes. Karuk are the best known for their superior baskets. They're called the Acamela Odama baskets. They were made from grasses, rushes, willow, cattails, and or devil's claw.
Tools and materials used. They fished and traveled using canoes. Hunters used bow and arrows and snares. Fishers used nets and spears to lure in the fish. And just in general, they used stones, caved rock, carved rocks into sharp knives, axes, and bolas. It's just a string connected to round rocks.
Spirituality and religion. Spirituality and religion were an important part in the Karuk tribe. They believed to have secret powers of witchcraft, which they could use maliciously to make their neighbors sicken and die. The sucking doctor, who was usually a spiritual helper to extract diseases objects from bodies of patients. Certain myths said that the singing of associated songs were believed to confer magical success in hunting, gambling, and love. And here are the links. Hope you enjoyed. Bye, y'all.
Bye.